of the WWE Women's Tag Team Champions, Bianca Belair.
Wade, I've got to ask you, is there anything in this world that Bianca Belair cannot do and do well? She's already half of the Women's Tag Team Champions, the first overall pick in the 2024 draft, and perhaps our next Queen of the Ring.
Well, Bianca Belair clearly has an insatiable hunger to achieve more and more and more. I'm not sure when she will ever hit that limit, but I'm enjoying the show in the meantime.
And her opponent from Prior Lake, Minnesota, Tiffany Stratton.
Hey, Tiffany Stratton, a young lady who many members in the WWE universe find to be borderline intolerable. How bad do you think it could be if Stratton becomes Queen of the Ring?
Well, she's arrogant, she's conceited, self-centered, but more than anything, she's really, really good when it comes to professional wrestling, as she's proven over the past couple of years in NXT and now here on SmackDown. And yeah, I guarantee you that, Corey. Stratton becomes Queen of the Ring, we will never hear the end of it.
Let's take a look at our Queen of the Ring brackets and how we arrived at this point. Tiffany Stratton getting the best of Mi Chin, and Bianca Belair getting past Candice LeRae, leading us to this matchup. Who will be the next to advance in the Queen of the Ring tournament and head to Jeddah, Saudi Arabia for the King and Queen of the Ring premium live event 1 week from tomorrow?
Well, listen, Corey, this is two women who, for me, are the two best athletes in the entire women's division, and that is really saying something. The interesting thing is they may be equals in terms of athleticism. That is their main advantage in every match they ever have. Well, in this case, it's completely neutralized.
And I would imagine that's almost unfamiliar territory for Bianca Belair, who has not really had a physical equal since her arrival in WWE.
Yeah, but enter the Olympic level gymnast, Tiffany Stratton, throwing everything at Belair from the word go.
Tiffany Stratton seemingly extremely confident in the early moments of this matchup, and that could be Stratton's best weapon, not buying into the aura of the EST.
Yeah, a lot of times the EST has women beat before the bell rings, but not in this case. Tiffany Stratton believes she is the best on the planet, bar none, regardless of resume or experience.
First, we take a look back at Tiffany Stratton utilizing the braid to rip Belair off of her feet, and a cover at the top of your screen momentarily. And Stratton capitalized, but here comes Belair. Of course, you've got Bianca's tag team partner, her tag team championship partner, Jade Cargill, in action tonight against Nia Jax. Belair having a little bit of fun at the expense of the center of the universe. Great athleticism by Belair, and Stratton a step ahead.
These two women so well matched up. It may well come down to a mental battle between these two. Who can outfox the other? Because physically, they are a complete match.
Now, I agree with you, Wade. I think this could come down to which of these two superstars makes the first mistake. WWE Universe trying to rally behind Bianca Belair. Oh, gut buster by Bianca. Oh, wait, notice Belair favoring her left knee, which presented a bit of a problem in her matchup last week with Candice LeRae. Belair fighting through the pain. Moonsault connects. Cover here.
Yeah, I'm glad you mentioned that knee issue from last week with LeRae. I brought it up with Bianca earlier today. She said it will not be an issue at all tonight. However, clearly moving quite gingerly at the moment.
And now it's Bianca Belair raining down heavy rights on Stratton, who escapes and again looks to use the braid of Belair.
The old-fashioned tug of war that the EST won.
Stratton gets a face full of turnbuckle for her troubles. And the EST giving chase, but again, Stratton utilizing the braid. Oh! And Bianca's leg caught in the ropes. This could prove catastrophic for the EST's Queen of the Ring dreams.
Yeah, twisting that previously damaged knee in a horrible fashion. It wasn't playing up earlier today. It certainly is now, and that is a game-changing moment in this match.
Stratton in complete control. Is the EST outgunned tonight?